My name is Merrick Gertler, and it is my great privilege to serve the University of Toronto as its 16th president. Today, I have the additional privilege of assisting Chancellor Rose Patton in conducting this special honorary degree ceremony. I bid a warm welcome to everyone who has joined us virtually from around the globe. In compliance with public health directives in the province of Ontario to help stop the spread of COVID-19, we are conferring all honorary degrees virtually. In normal times, this ceremony would have occurred during a convocation ceremony, where we gather in person to celebrate the achievements of our U of T graduates and our honorary degree recipients together. And so I would like to thank our honorary graduate, Professor Elizabeth Cannon, for agreeing to accept the University of Toronto's highest honor under these unique circumstances. I would also like to thank Professor Emeritus Gerard LaChapelle for agreeing to serve as hooder, an important ceremonial role in the conferral portion of the convocation ceremony. It is now my great honor to present Professor Elizabeth Cannon. Throughout her esteemed career, Elizabeth Cannon has been an exceptional leader and tireless ambassador in academics, science, and technology in Canada and beyond. Her distinguished contributions span many areas and include education, research, policy, outreach, administrative leadership, and community service. Dr. Cannon is President Emerita and Professor of Geomatics Engineering at the University of Calgary. Under her leadership, UCalgary launched a comprehensive advancement strategy, oversaw a highly successful fundraising campaign, and expanded its campus infrastructure with multiple new cutting-edge facilities. Dr. Cannon's research has been on the forefront of global positioning systems for close to four decades in both industrial and academic environments, and she has commercialized technology to over 200 agencies worldwide. She has served on the National Advisory Board on Earth Sciences for the Canadian Minister of Natural Resources, as a member of the Federal Science, Technology, and Innovation Council, as president of the U.S. Institute of Navigation, and as chair of Universities Canada, in addition to leadership roles on many other boards and advisory councils. In recognition of her many contributions as a researcher, educator, and leader, Dr. Cannon has been honored with more than 80 national and international fellowships and awards. She has been elected a Fellow of the Royal Society of Canada and the Canadian Academy of Engineering, a foreign member of the U.S. National Academy of Engineering, and in 2019, she was inducted as an officer of the Order of Canada. For her excellence in the Academy, as a leading researcher and a tireless ambassador for science and technology in Canada and globally, Chancellor Patton, on behalf of the Governing Council, I ask you to confer the degree of Doctor of Laws, honoris causa, upon Elizabeth Cannon.
On behalf of the University of Toronto and by virtue of the authority vested in me, I have the great honor and pleasure of conferring on you, Elizabeth Cannon, the degree of Doctor of Laws, honoris causa.
As the newest member of the University of Toronto alumni, Dr. Cannon, I extend warmest congratulations on behalf of the entire U of T community. I now invite you to deliver your address.
Chancellor, President, families, and most especially fellow graduates, thank you for this honor. I'm thrilled to be part of the class of 2021. Congratulations. As a former engineering professor and university president, I know the hard work it took to get to this moment. And I also know the pride that your families justifiably feel in your accomplishments and your potential for the future. I want to speak to three attributes you each have demonstrated in reaching this milestone, attributes that will serve you well as you embark on the next phase of your life and career. The first is preparation. As members of the class of 2021, you are Canada's best prepared, technically current graduates. The pandemic has shown the value of engineering in our daily lives. Think of communication systems or vaccine development, transportation, and distribution on scales undreamt of just a few years ago. Canada will rely on your curiosity, creativity, and entrepreneurial skills to rebuild our economy and society. This is a tremendous opportunity for you to do what engineers do best, make a difference in our world. The second attribute is resilience. Each of you has paved your own path. At the same time, you are all inextricably connected through your shared experiences, some generationally unique. Your ability to find support, build community, and empathize with others is the human side of engineering. Be personally resilient while nurturing the resiliency of others. And your third attribute is leadership. True leadership is not merely a title, it is expressed. Being proactive, accountable, and motivated by goals larger than your own. You are logical thinkers, problem solvers, and impact driven. I urge you to think of yourselves as leaders now, in your profession and community. Lead with a heart and mind, and others will follow. Preparation, resilience, and leadership. These three attributes have served you well and will continue to do so, whatever you choose to do. Of course, my engineering education influenced me throughout my career, but I believe these attributes are universally important, whether you are an engineering, science, business, or history graduate. After all, it's not about what you do, but about how you do it that matters. This observation has been a cornerstone of my professional career as an engineer. It shaped my leadership style and my belief in ethics and integrity. It has enriched my life, and I'm sure it will enrich yours too. Best wishes to each of you, and congratulations on your tremendous achievement.
Thank you, Dr. Cannon, and let me say you have inspired us with your lifetime career and accomplishments. And today, you have inspired us with your words. We are delighted to count you among the most distinguished members of our alumni community. And in closing, I offer warm congratulations to you and to all graduates in the class of 2021.